esportsbets.com, a unique place for true gamers. The only place to bet on esports events. You know your way around a competitive gaming scene and are willing to take a risk? Watch regular broadcasts and earn real money. esportsbets.com. Foresight, passion, and calculation.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Star Series 10, the LAN finals here. Four teams, three of them remain, and we're about to find out who are going to get into the grand finals. Now, my name is Semler, this is Room on Fire, and with me, I hope, is Vendetta. Ven, are you here?
Of course I'm here.
Damn straight, bro. Wouldn't have it any other way.
Now, well, we kind of have to be here. It's NaVi versus HellRaisers. How can we miss that?
This is it, man. It's the rematch from yesterday. Now we get to see if HellRaisers, you know, they took out XMG earlier in the best of three, the first best of three of the day, to see who was going to take fourth place. But now HellRaisers get a second crack at NaVi, the team that put them down here to begin with.
Yeah, and you can bet your life that HellRaisers are eager to get, if not, well, a complete domination, they'll definitely get some revenge for last night, because they got pretty pummeled on Dust2, and they gave it to NaVi on Inferno, but they still ended up losing 16-14. So HellRaisers have something to prove, not to themselves only, but to everyone who's been a fan of that team for quite some time.
Yeah, that's the thing right now. I mean, they came into Gamescom and had a bit of a rough start, HellRaisers. They took 16-1 to the face, got knocked out in the groups, couldn't quite make it through, so a bit of a disappointing tournament. This was going to be the tournament that they were going to bounce back in. And even going into this tournament, you know, they were kind of goofing around, joking around about it, you know, saying, hell, well, guys, at least we can promise you a top four finish, right? So there is a little levity there, you know, HellRaisers. They're trying to take a little bit of the punch out, but you know that these guys, they're in this tournament right now to prove that they are definitely a top contender, that they are a team to be taken seriously. And here's the opportunity. Take out NaVi in this best of three on LAN. That would be a huge statement from HellRaisers, and it means that they would be able to go on to the finals to face off against Fnatic, who beat NaVi yesterday in the winner bracket final.
Exactly. And, I think it's fair to say that the game last night had, well, quite a few mistakes in them, but yeah, that's kind of the cool thing, because we already saw in the first game of the day that HellRaisers had corrected a lot of those mistakes and were looking on point. So if they're able to keep that level up and avoid making simple mistakes, like, well, they had a couple versus MaxMG, for instance. We talked about the Doge re-peeking instead of that allowed PNX to get that sick clutch, that type of thing. But if they just limit those mistakes, they have a really good shot at actually taking out NaVi and getting to the grand finals and getting a shot at Fnatic.
Yeah, that's the thing. Fnatic are the big beasts in this tournament. They went through their first best of three. They clinched the second best of three versus NaVi as well after a close map on Inferno. Well, not Fnatic really have looked like the team to beat this entire tournament long. Yeah. So they are going to be the Colossus waiting at the end of this trail. Now the question is, who's going to face them between HellRaisers and NaVi? And HellRaisers, I think, do have a bit of an edge going into this best of three now, because they've already played one best of three today. So they've had a little bit of time to get warmed up, to get in that zone where, you know, it's all or nothing and they have to hit the shots. And they did so earlier versus XMG. Now we have to see if they can do it versus NaVi. The maps for this best of three are going to be as follows. NaVi vetoed Nuke. No surprise there. HR took out Train. Again, no surprise. They don't want to play NaVi on Train. So NaVi went with the first pick. This map right here, Dust 2. Let me see. HellRaisers took Inferno as their second map, and the decider then is going to be Mirage, because this is a five map pool after all.
So we're going to see the exact same scenario as yesterday.
Pretty much.
That's what it comes down to. NaVi picking Dust2, HellRaisers picking up Inferno, and we didn't get to see Mirage last night, which is a bummer because both of these teams are excellent on that map, and the last time they played, actually, it ended up in a tie. So who knows? Maybe HellRaisers have managed to eke out the tiny mistakes they did on Inferno to maybe grab that map, or who knows? Maybe they've looked through what NaVi did on Dust2 from yesterday and managed to adapt something to that for tonight.
Yeah, you can be sure that these guys have definitely been watching the matches. I mean, it's a great venue over there. Plenty of couches, plenty of seating space. The whole venue is pretty much designed for these kinds of shows, for these kinds of tournaments, to have the teams up on the stage. So you can be sure that the players, you know, they're probably lounging about on the couches, you know, with their heads together, going over any little mistake, any little tick that they could pick up from Na'Vi. Because Na'Vi at this point, my XMG, they put up a strong fight, but they were brought in because Mouse Sports did not want to take their spot here at this finals. They decided to bow out at the last second, and so my XMG were brought in to replace them. But my XMG, despite putting up a strong fight, kind of finished fourth. And I think going into this tournament, you know, everybody kind of expected them to finish fourth. They didn't get crushed doing it, but they did wind up being the first team out. Now, HellRaisers Na'Vi was going to be the battle that we were all going to be wondering about pretty much, because Fnatic, I think anybody, you know, going into this tournament would have said that Fnatic are definitely the top team. I mean, they're the finalists at Gamescom, only just barely losing out to NiP in the finals. So Fnatic are definitely in a good place right now. They have got to be, you know, that final raid boss that everybody's gonna be looking to take a piece out of.
Oh, for sure. There's absolutely no doubt about that. And what I'm excited to see if whether or not yesterday when they played, Guardian came up so big for Na'Vi in so many ways, together with Starks and Suze. And I'm curious to see if they're gonna be able to have a repeat performance from that game. Because I think Na'Vi needs Guardian to be an absolute monster if they want to beat HellRaisers. And if Doja continues his form from the first best of three, then that's going to be a scary omen for Na'Vi if they don't have a Guardian in tip-top shape.
All right, well, we're about to get live with the first pistol here of this best of three. This is the consolidation finals of Star Series 10. You are watching it here on Room on Fire. Thank you all for joining us today. It's a fine Sunday, and we got some good CS to entertain us. So now we get to see exactly what HellRaisers have in store for us, and it looks like a full-out, all-out YOLO rush, straight-up cat, looking to catch Na'Vi off guard. And Na'Vi, not to be disappointed, are going to lob a nade in there. Zeus is going to be the point man holding it across, and he's already trying to put pressure on HellRaisers, but HellRaisers, they get right onto that site and get the perfect plant that they were looking for.
And they're actually in pretty good afterplant positions. Na'Vi do have a couple of nades to work with, but still, this is going to be a tough retake for Na'Vi.
That's not an ideal situation. Zeus gets caught out on the slope, and that's not going to help things. Guardian taking a little bit of damage as well, but at least Guardian and C's both taking kills. We're into a 3-on-3 now. Make that a 3-on-2 as Guardian finds yet another frag, but Adrian replies, brings it back to a 2-on-2, and Doja, alive on cat, is going to try and keep Starks off of this bomb. Starks, unfortunately for him, has no kit, and it's past the point of no return. There is no defusing now, and Starks will go up with that bomb. Adrian, confident, after Doja sacrificed himself, knew exactly how much time was left and that it was not going to be possible for Na'Vi. So HellRaisers will pick up the first round.
Great start for HellRaisers, no doubt. Kind of looked a tiny bit shaky during the afterplant with Guardian picking up a frag and, with everything that happened. But them having Adrian kind of lurking around in mid and actually poking at people from the spawn area bought so much time for HellRaisers, and eventually that's kind of what won them the round, seeing how, well, the bomb went off and Na'Vi didn't have a defuse kit. So that's well played by HellRaisers, using the time to their advantage.
No, Guardian. We got a double scout play here from Na'Vi in the second round. I really like this. Seeing more and more of the scout in use. Makes sense that C's would pick it up because he's going to be holding on B site. That's his usual position. And the scout could be pretty deadly looking into upper dark. But Guardian is the one taking the fight at mid right now. And he's already tagged up Markleoff and Doja both. So good damage dealt already by Guardian early on in this round. Just softening up HellRaisers so that when push comes to shove, it'll be easier for his mates over on the B site to deal with this push that's about to come in, and already sees instantly Gibbs Kuchar, and Edward is in a great position to pick up a second frag. He could go for a third one as well, and he will get it.
And that's absolutely devastating if you're HellRaisers at that point. And that is really nice setup though from Na'Vi and C's being able to work as a bait really for Edward long enough for him to pick up two kills.
Not sure if Angel knows that that Starks is closing in so quickly behind. He's going to get the instant shot on Doja, who is holding a back plateau. Zeus gets caught off guard, though. Angel, with the MAC-10, rushes him down on B slope, and he's going to be looking for Starks. Starks has to land the perfect shot with the Swag 7 right now, and he sees Angel dancing. Angel's just trying to buy as much time as possible, but there you go, the casual shot. And Starks, the real question is, does he manage to have the time to get the defuse? He doesn't have a kit, and we're down to 5 seconds now. It's going to be so close, but I don't think he's going to get it. I think the bomb is going to go off with a minute with the second left. And Starks, despite getting in there and getting that final frag, he's just not fast enough.
So that's two rounds in a row where HellRaisers are winning based off of time. And given how that round initially played out for them, I think they'll have to be happy with the fact that they got the round at all. Because Angel got that last frag on the guy outside of B with 9 HP left, so he could have easily gone down. But still, 2-0 for HellRaisers, and they have to be content with that, even though their weaponry isn't optimal at this point.
Not at all, yeah. Taking way too much damage. I mean, one guy surviving in the pistol, one guy surviving in the second round. Or not even, actually. Everybody getting wiped out in the second round. So, yeah, we can see it right now in the guns. Markolov, again, just going with the Glock and armor. No rifle picked up for him because he wants to get that that AWP as quickly as possible. Fourth round buy will be coming around here for NaVi after this round of eco. And right now, NaVi haven't invested too much. They've only picked up two CZ-75s to deal with this push on Cat. And Zeus, despite the fact that he doesn't have a CZ, puts the P2K to work and actually picks up a frag. So that's going to be pretty nice here. Markolov will find C's trying to poke about, and Kucher is going to be able to shut down Edward here. And this is the last man alive for NaVi. Although Edward somehow finds the angle, gets there ahead of Kucher, and finds a shot on him. So two kills again for NaVi, doing the damage here to HellRaisers.
Yeah, I think the saving grace for HellRaisers in that previous round was the fact that NaVi's investment in the first anti-eco was so heavy that they didn't, as you said, they didn't have that many CZ, they didn't have that many pistols really to do a lot of work with, and HellRaisers took full advantage of that. But this is the big round, and we see Guardian have picked up the AWP, going aggressively on Catwalk. He's actually going to miss a shot onto Doja, so that's a bit of a blunder there from Guardian. That's a shot he normally makes, but I think Doja's going to be pretty okay with that.
Yeah, at that point, well, I mean, a lot of the time, well, there you go, Guardian will find Adrian, but a good pop flash in, and Angel's just going to run and spray down Guardian, so that's a good return, not wasting any time. There's still two guys ready to defend on the B site, though. Edward overcommitting somewhat, takes one guy with him, brings it back to a 3-on-3, and now it's down to C's. He gets the first frag, he could go for the second, and he will get it. Two headshots for him, and this is going to crush the push now coming in here from HellRaisers. Kucher tries to turn tail and run, but C's does not let him go. And Edward giving the information, allowing Seized to be able to set up properly, and Seized not messing up one bit.
That was just an excellent hold from Seized. The only thing I think we could fault HellRaisers for doing is Kucher being a tiny bit too late on his push and from the upper B bomb site. If he had been just 2 seconds earlier, he would have been able to catch Seized as he walked over from his hiding spot over to the plateau to make quick work of the NaVi. Now HellRaisers players that were incoming, but still great hold from Seized.
I think NaVi are really confident in their ability to retake here. They've really focused a lot on long, had three guys floating down there, leaving Cat completely open. Now they've focused or rotated Zeus back over to A slope. He's about to get some help from Guardian as well, but HellRaisers, they are intent on taking this bomb site, working straight up Cat, and they're running straight into the blender. Guardian has two kills already, goes in for a third. He could pick up a fourth as well. Angel manages to get back off of Cat just in the nick of time to stay alive, but all five members remain here for NaVi. And this is the way to bounce back for NaVi in the fifth round. They're going to shut it down with a perfect clean sweep. And HellRaisers, that was all the money they had.
Yep, that was a force buy coming out from HellRaisers, and it didn't work out at all. Not picking up a single kill. So NaVi are going to have a bit of a cushion to stabilize their economy. And as long as they can limit their losses in this anti-eco, they should be on a great path to having a really good first half.
Now, what they have to worry about, right? Yeah, exactly. Well, it's NaVi just getting control here, getting momentum, and that's a scary thing. You do not, especially when you are considered the underdog in this match, which is the case for HellRaisers, you do not want to be giving NaVi an easy time of things. So this is definitely a start HellRaisers were avoiding, or trying to avoid. Edward and Guardian turning mid into a bit of a shooting gallery right now, just cutting down this eco play here from HellRaisers, who have only gone with a couple CZs. Kucher does manage to find a kill on C's, so that's good work there, but Edward instantly replies, and Zeus will hunt down Kucher on Cat for the final frag. 2-2 and 1, it goes, and NaVi only lose one guy, which is actually pretty good, all things considered.
Yeah. Guardian could have easily went down that round, and if they've all of a sudden gotten 2 and, who knows, maybe 3, if Edward kept re-peeking, that would have been an excellent round for HellRaisers, but I guess from the point of HellRaisers' view, you have to look at it as one is better than none at that point, so any damage done is going to help you in the long run.
That's true. And they're definitely, I mean, it's a game of inches right now, pretty much. You know, who can get the slight edge over their team, over their opponents? And NaVi right now still have a bit of a bank to hold on to. So even if they were to lose this round, it's not the end of the world for them. They can bounce back. It's HellRaisers who, after that round of eco, have enough to get a reasonable buy-in. Everybody with AKs, everybody with full Kevlar helmet. But the nades are a little bit light on HellRaisers' side. They still get what they need, but you can tell that they didn't have enough for like a full buy. And that means that they don't have a whole lot left in the bank either. So it's all about stopping Na'Vi right here for HellRaisers. They need to find the entry frags. And they're really taking their time with it, initially with a 1-3-1 setup, but now starting to converge on mid. So where do you think they're going to take this from here, Ren?
I wouldn't be too surprised if it's obvious, but that's something that both Na'Vi and HellRaisers really like to do. And I think it would be very beneficial for them as well, because Guardian only has an AWP. So for him to run through that smoke, that's risky, to say the least. If they're able to sandwich Edward and Seized in, that should be a perfect opportunity for HellRaisers to actually get that B bomb site. But they have to commit more than just Angel, who's the only guy out in mid right now.
Well, they've managed to actually sneak Angel up B slope right now. They may actually catch him off guard. Edward is still just jumping around at window. There's the flash through, but Angel's already knocking, and Edward somehow gets the kill. Angel missing a huge opportunity. Adrian and Doja will get the kills at the end. But that was a very close call there. HellRaisers were very close to losing control of the situation.
That was a scary moment. Markleff, though, is in a great position right now to punish anyone from Na'Vi trying to rotate over.
Oh, they're even going to get the flash out, but Guardian point blanks him. Zeus will find the headshot on Kucher, and now it's the man advantage for Na'Vi with this retake. And not too much time has gone off this bomb as well, so there's still time to act. But Adrian clicking away, he's pulling an Edward right now. He's just going ahead, taking his time, setting this up. And Doja, Adrian, each getting frags. They just shut it down. Both of them hardly taking any damage at all in the retake.
Oh, that was a great hold from Doja and Adrian. And it looked very scary for HellRaisers there for a second because, well, first off, I think Angel should have survived that situation, or at least he should have been able to take down Edward before he went down. So that was a bit unfortunate from his side. And Markleff got a bit too eager in mid there, and he went, after seeing the gun barrel of Zeus, he kind of just rammed after and tried to shoot him while running and shooting. That didn't work out because Guardian had Zeus's back from CT spawn, and that could have easily turned out to snowball in favor of Na'Vi, but luckily for them, Doja and Adrian sort things out in the end.
Yeah, I didn't catch who was pushing at B doors, but Adrian, I mean, he instantly turns it into a 2-on-2 and spots the man out in upper dark as well. So just, I think Adrian really being the point man there for that hold, because that could have definitely gone Na'Vi's way if Adrian doesn't land that shot at B doors early on.
Yeah, but as you mentioned, Na'Vi could still buy up. We can see Guardian still rocking the AWP, and they've got a pretty decent setup here.
Oh man, the double spray, and Doja's gonna get it. He gets caught by Guardian in the end, who's holding from A slope, but that was a really wonky entry onto A site there. Doja gets two kills, but he gets taken out.
Look,
now we're
Edward
back into a 3-on-3, but Edward's on a mission right now, and he could potentially catch all of HellRaisers completely off guard here. And there you go, surprise, surprise! But somehow, Edward is the one to miss it this time.
I guess that's karma for you.
That's...
So got a tattoo lucky with not dying to Angel last round, and this time around it's Adrian who somehow escapes the jaws of death.
Man, yeah, that was okay. I was completely convinced that was going to go Edward's way, at least get one kill there. But Markleff will find Guardian, who is jumping towards long, trying to get out of harm's way as HellRaisers push up Cat. And with 10 seconds left, HellRaisers will get this bomb plant on the A site, seized with only 20 points of health. All three members from HellRaisers on this site. It's a bit too tough a nut to crack, and it seems like he's just going to be content to sit over in suicide and try and hold on to his gun. And with good reason right now, actually. This win from HellRaisers, the last round, but this one as well, has done a lot to Na'Vi's economy.
Yeah, and I'm actually curious to see whether or not Na'Vi are going to force it up if Seize manages to hold on to this weapon, because as you can see, Seize and Starks both have 2.5 and 2.6k after this round, so they're going to have something to work with. So I guess with the way Na'Vi have been playing up to this point, I wouldn't be too surprised if we saw Zeus and Starks buy up and have Edward and Guardian rocking either Scouts and Zeus's or something to that effect.
Let's see, yeah. And it looks like it's going to be CZ's. So it seems Na'Vi are content to sit back. I mean, we can't forget that they're still on the, I suppose, on the less favored side of Dust 2.
Yeah.
Know, with that in mind, we've been seeing a lot of teams go the distance and get, you know, 6, 7, 8 rounds even on the CT side. What do you think Na'Vi will be comfortable with at the end of this first half?
It's a tough call, especially if you have to, well, if Na'Vi has to gauge it from how last night's game went. From that standpoint, they'd probably be fine with 4 or 5 rounds. But this definitely seems like a different HellRaisers than what we saw yesterday. So I think Na'Vi has to get probably 6 rounds to feel somewhat comfortable, if not more.
All right. Well, let's look at the setup here, because Seized is currently pushed up close to mid doors. Flash should be going through here. Angel did take a peek, but nothing's going to come of it. And Zeus is falling back. He spots out Doja on Cat. And he has support there from Starix as well. The Hellraisers have yet to make a real play, a real push onto any site here. Want to take their time and see if Na'Vi are going to be the ones getting antsy, trying to push forward and give them a free kill. Seems like it's going to be a B play after all. Everybody through Upper Dark, in fact. Nobody going through mid-doors right now. Apart from Angel, who's kind of floating around to cut off the rotation, but Starks insta-gives him, and now the B play begins. Hellraiser's just trying to rush out, and Edward already getting a frag. There could be another one here. Starks gets caught by Kocher, and now Hellraiser's, it's turned into a real brawl on this site. They can't get control of it. Guardian is still alive, and he's just holding. If he dances like this, it's huge. And Seized is still alive at the doors as well as cutting them down as they try and cross to the site. But with 20 seconds left, Kucher's the last man alive, and Seized decides to push in. I know that's anticlimactic and everything, but why did Seized feel like it was necessary to push into that site?
Well, I think he got the information that Kucher was actually in need of a reload, basically. So Kucher had to get some sort of cover. And I actually thought that Seized chose the perfect timing to push in as well. Mm-hmm. Because Kucher was down to 22 HP. That's just two bullets through that wooden box at the edge of the B entrance. So that could have easily gone Seize's destroy. I actually was pretty convinced that Seize would be able to pick that round up, but that was a great shot from Kucher to save the round for Hellraisers. And that's big for Hellraisers, because if Na'Vi lose this round, they're going to have to double eco.
Yeah, they're putting everything into this. Guardian somehow finds a shot on Angel through the smoke, though. Markloff trying to return, but he's going to get caught by Edward too quick there, and Seized is only alive on this side. Zeus comes rushing through at CT, and he's not going to get a kill. So we're into a 3-on-3 once again. Hellraiser's having taken tremendous damage, but they're getting the kills nonetheless. Seized is off of this B site, and now the bomb has been planted. The real question is, do they go for this retake, Na'Vi? Because it's certainly, I mean, they're certainly thinking about their money right now. Is it worth risking the guns?
If they can get a really quick frag, Kucher actually gives them that frag, so now it's all onto Adrian.
Oh, sick first shot there by Adrian, catching Guardian instantly. But you're right, oh man, that was another kill onto Doja, I believe. Two kills, and one of them unforced, basically. An unforced error made by Hellraisers with an HE killing off one of the teammates. Yeah, Seized is just... Seized.
Yeah.
The lol.
Basking in the pain of Kucher, I guess. But yeah, that was really unfortunate from Hellraisers. I was about to compliment them on how they play that B split, because Kucher this time around was quicker on attacking from the upper bomb side, and he was able to take out Seize before Seize got anything done, really. So that was really nicely done by them as Guardian picks up Kucher, but there we go, the return from Adrian instantly, and he's actually going to pick up Seuss as well, and that leaves Starks alone on 8 slope here, and he's gonna have a tough time holding this off if Hellers just decide to commit.
But look at the push coming in here from Seized and Edward. They're gonna get baited out. Adrian, they turn back around, and Seized misses an opportunity as well. Adrian and Markloff getting two big kills. That opens up the B site for business. Hellraisers can now run right in. They know that the defense is gone. They've just killed it off, and Starks just goes rushing through the CT smoke out onto B slope. But Markloff and Angel are both waiting for him, and Hellraisers will pick up a 7th round. And now we are looking at a situation where Na'Vi may have to double eco. Three of them basically are sub $1,600 right now.
Yeah, barring a pretty risky force buy, they're gonna have to double eco. And that leaves, obviously, Hellraisers in a pretty advantageous situation right now. And they're doing so much better, as Markloff picks up Seuss, so much better than last night. You can definitely, you could taste the improvement, right?
And there's a huge difference already. Confidence as well, I think, is a big thing here. We're really seeing Hellraisers, I mean, sure, making some weird mistakes with like an HE, stuff like that, but still walking forward and getting trades that are allowing them to actually continue to pressure Na'Vi. Those one for ones are huge. It favors the T side. HR are definitely looking to be in a pretty healthy situation, and I'm wondering if, you know, that opening best of three of the day, you know, was enough to get them sufficiently warmed up for this match versus Na'Vi, because Na'Vi do seem a little bit cold.
Yeah, one big difference from the game last night is the fact that, well, Doja's gotten off to a good start. Sure, he's died 10 times, but he's picked up 11 frags. And if Doja gets frags, that's always good for you if you're Hellraisers, and Adrian as well, playing a huge game so far. And as Angel picks up Starix, and barring Seize doing something crazy, this should be an easy Hellraiser round.
Yep, Seize does take one with him with the USPS, but it's going to be Angel looking towards short, finds Edward, doesn't know that Guardian is there as well. But Guardian at this point, Not really sure how he wants to position himself to see if he can get something big going here. Angel is just waiting for him to push through Lower Dark right now, so I'm not sure if Guardian is going to have the opportunity. But he does have a CZ, so he could get around an angle here and try and hold. Wait for Angel to push around the corner. This is going to be a Hellraiser's round nonetheless. There you go, Guardian insta-give. Angel just gone instantly, and now he's got the M4A1, but Markolov is not going to let him use it. Instant kill there, and now Hellraiser sitting on the board with 8 rounds. 13th round coming up, and now we get to see, do Na'Vi force? And yes, they do. They don't even hesitate. Guardian goes for the instant M4A1 with Kevlar.
Yeah, they feel that they need to put a stop to Hellraiser's momentum right now. And even if they would have waited one round to buy up, they still would have had to eco for the final round of the half, and I think that's what led them to force up now, because that leaves them still with one more buy round.
Yeah, that's a good point. 13th round, there's 3 rounds left, this one included, so let's see how Na'Vi decide to hold this. Another thing is that Hellraisers, their money is kind of all over the place right now, so losing this round could lead to a weird force. There's going to be a push in Upper Dark right now. Kuchar does manage to hold somewhat, takes one with him. Edward is gone. Seized will be there to recuperate, however, and bring it back to a 4-on-4. Hellraisers aren't really focused on B at this point, they're focused on A.
Yeah, and I think that might be a mistake from Hellraiser's side. Okay, wait, we see Angel now kind of lurking about holding Lower Dark, and I think they need to spot out Seize. They need to get control over that area before they can safely move around. Otherwise, Seize can be a constant nuisance to them and the constant threat of a backstab, really.
Now, they kind of chase him off there. Seize decides he doesn't want to have anything to do with Lower Dark anymore. Angel, you know, Wrath, all of that. So he backs off to B site, ready to hold. There's still 3 members here for Na'Vi, and, well, Hellraisers are making plenty of noise here at long. Starx is still alive, waiting around the angle, just holding this angle. He's waiting for Adrian to come around the corner. Zeus will pick off Angel in the meantime. That was on Cat, but Starx gets one. He will not take out Doja, and Markolov finds Zeus on the A side proper. Now it's all down to Guardian, holding on CT slope. Markolov looking for the headshot, but he's not even going to bother. He's got 20 seconds. He can actually go for this plant, and Doja is in a position to be able to cover his back.
And now Doja, all Doja needs to do is basically get down into pit and hide. Just use the time to your advantage. Guardian has to push up through spawn, and ooh, as I say that.
What a shot! What a shot, Markolov! Seized, he picks Seized off from Cat, but then does the 180 in time to pick off Guardian. Instant headshot on Guardian. I'm sure Guardian thought he had that in the bag there.
I thought everyone thought Guardian had that in the bag. That was just an insane shot from Markolov. That was so fast that the model on my GoTV hadn't even turned around when Guardian died.
You know, it's like that's when you're wondering how fast can they do a 180 with the low sense? Because you can see Markolov going for one swipe and then having to do a second swipe to get there fast enough.
It was just madness. And Adrian keeps up the good form here, picking up 2 frags at long, kind of saving Doja there from certain doom. But Seust is kind of lurking behind here. He could actually catch people off guard. Doja with the built-in GPS just somehow knew that Seuss was coming around. He might have been spotted out by Kuchar, actually.
He might have been spotted by Kuchar, but I really like to see Hellraisers being so thorough and making sure that, you know, they're not giving Na'Vi any opportunity to sneak in anywhere to get any freebie kills. And Kuchar is at risk here. Seized could walk up behind him, and Seized is going to spot him. Nicely done there by Seized. 2 quick shots. Juan Dig is not here, but still, gets the job done with the Deagle and actually saves an AK, which could be really good for his team going into the next round. Granted, they're going to have money to buy, but an AK could mean the difference between somebody having full nades and somebody having to, well, get by without any, so let's see. Sees peeks around the corner, he's instantly going to get caught. Edward is there to pick up the gun, and he's going to try and turn tail and run. Only problem is that Doja is here, and Doja denies the escape, so Hellraiser's now sitting on 10 rounds here on the first map in this first half, and we go into the 15th round. Na'Vi, they're all floating around the 4,500, 5K mark, so they will be able to get a pretty healthy buy going into this. It's not the end of the world that they didn't save that AK, but I'm sure they wouldn't have been too bad a thing.
I really wouldn't, and I think this is a must-have round if you're Na'Vi at this point. Because the tables have completely turned from last night, and the Hellraisers are just playing so much better in every aspect of the game, and Na'Vi definitely need to pick up 5 rounds on the CT side if they want to have a shot at getting back to this.
There's going to be so much pressure on Na'Vi once they switch over to the T side regardless. 4 or 5 rounds. I mean, 5 rounds would be great, but it's still very tough for them. Good pop flash into Longhouse to clear out Starx. Adrian jumps on the opportunity and gets that frag. So, you know, it's things like this. It's the little details. Hellraiser's just being so thorough. pop flashing into house, you know, making sure that they can't get sneaked up on, watching all the angles and just being very careful with their play. All of this means that Na'Vi really don't have too much to work with here. Seize is trying to push into upper dark through B slope, or at least he's holding on the edge of the smoke, but that is, I mean, he is the only man here holding this site. If he gets rushed down, that's it, it's open. Oh, and he gets the first spray, but it's not going to be good enough. Markloff is there to return instantly. Guardian, or Edward rather, has rotated into position to be able to lend a hand, but it's going to be into a two-on-two now as they exchange shots. Guardian is waiting at the doors, and he's been smoked off. No opportunity to look through. He actually goes jumping through, and point-blank catches Kuchar, and Markloff brings it back, but Zeus not able to do it. Markloff again, the 1v2 clutch from him.
Markloff is just playing out of his mind right now. Holy hell. He's been coming up in the clutch for HellRaisers big time the last few rounds. And what's really fun to see is that, as you mentioned, you know, they're doing the tiny details as like pop flashing for each other and that type of thing. When I guess the HellRaisers F team, as we call them, or the B team shows up.
Right, right.
They'll take that peek without anyone flashing for them, right? And oftentimes they'll get picked off that way. When HellRaisers play like this and they play as a unit, they're so insanely strong, and to win the TF versus a team like Na'Vi 11-4, that's incredible.
That is, I mean, this is a score that really gives the HellRaisers a huge lead going into the second half. I mean, that is a really strong score considering how many score lines we've seen where it's even been like 8-7 or even the CT side coming out ahead. Now, all of a sudden, HellRaisers, it's like we're going back in time 6 months to, oh, wait, you know, this is a T-sided map, right? We expect to see the T-side come out pretty far ahead like this. So, HellRaisers, 11 rounds on the board. If they pick up the pistol, they could even just run away completely with this first map right here. And going into Inferno, that boost in confidence will be very difficult for Na'Vi to deal with because HellRaisers are also very good on that map.
Yeah, HellRaisers brought it to Na'Vi on Inferno, and that was after getting pummeled on Dust too. Now they're giving the pummeling. And that has to feel great, knowing that your map pick is what's coming up next. And that also has to be worrying for Na'Vi. So I think they have to pick up a pistol and they have to get on a good run so they can at least say that they had a good streak in the first map if they eventually lose it.
Yeah, I think you're right. And it seems like it's going to be fast pressure towards Longhouse right now. We've got three guys gathering up, waiting for the nades. No nades come. Now they sneak forward. Doja is here, however, and Doja just doing a lot of damage, but not getting a kill. There's still Markloff alive around this corner, but Markloff has just turned tail and run, and he somehow makes it out alive with 7 points of health. Adrian in position to get up, boosted up onto the site, and Angel already rotated over as well. Very quick rotation coming out here from HellRaisers. They aren't wasting any time. They do not want to lose any kind of control in this map. If they can strike right back at Na'Vi, they jump on the opportunity.
This is the same pistol that Na'Vi used yesterday, actually. And we can see this time, well, not working out either.
Oh, this is really brutal now. It's going to be Zeus caught on. I mean, they dropped the bomb on Cat. Zeus trying to get to it, but HellRaisers are keeping them off of this bomb, and Seized is now the only man alive. He's coming from the wrong way up on A site, but there's two guys here. They're about to get flashed in. Seized is totally blind, and HellRaisers do a fantastic job of getting the read and just keeping their cool in this second half pistol.
That was a really nice read from HellRaisers. I think they, as soon as Doja went down to that long push, I think they realized pretty quickly that this is the same pistol strategy that Na'Vi used on us last night. So, last night, what happened was basically Adrian coming up in the clutch and getting two insane USP shots through middle double doors.
Yep.
This time around, they kind of just stacked around the area without aggressively peeking them. And Na'Vi fell into that trap and basically got introduced to the firing squad.
They're going to get introduced to it again here. Adrian will find Edward, who is trying to sneak up for a dig shot, but not meant to be. I love that Seized has actually picked up a Tech 9. I wonder if this is a miss buy because he's literally got like 6 frags on that gun. It's a stat track. So, yeah, he's got 6 frags on it.
Well, some people do actually pick it up, like pick up wonky weapons quite
sometimes you see
often.
It.
Yeah, they have a trend of doing that. Some players like get right picks up the dualies and that type of thing. So, I don't think it's a miss buy because it does a lot of damage. It's just that the accuracy of it isn't quite up to par with the other pistols.
Well, when you think spray and pray, you think Tech 9, right?
Yeah.
That's pretty much it. Well, you know, hey, unless you land a first click like that, Seized with the headshot on Kuchar to start. Good work there. Markloff doing his best to stay alive, but he's going to get rushed down. Starx going forward with the Seized head. Bomb has been dropped out a little bit in the middle of nowhere, but Adrian is looking to take a fight fairly quickly here at window, and they are just going to push in. Angel whipping around. 180 shot, gets two kills, and now it's just Angel trying to dance as best he can. Starix gets caught on the plateau, and HellRaisers, they actually recover somewhat there in that round.
It's crazy. HellRaisers have gotten every situation where something crazy happens, things have gone in the favor of HellRaisers. Markloff's 2v1s and Angel pushing in there. He could have easily gotten taken out after getting that first kill, and that would have meant probably an easy run for Na'Vi from there on out. Instead, he manages to pick up the two frags and finally finish it off with a triple kill. That was just crazy.
I'm really impressed. Starix had an opportunity, but Angel just no fear, man. That was really nicely done there, and that's just HellRaisers not willing to give an inch, not willing to give anything to Na'Vi to work with. Angel again, you speak his name, he's summoned. He's already wreaking havoc here at mid. This is an anti-eco round for HellRaisers. And another thing is that HellRaisers, their anti-eco rounds, at least right now, have been seeming pretty... They seem to be pretty on point. They're not giving anything away, and if this shapes up to be a perfect anti-eco, that is fantastic for HellRaisers. They have so much space now. I mean, a 10-round lead is nothing to sneeze at.
It's huge. It's absolutely massive for them, and what you mentioned just there is something that HellRaisers have been having so much trouble with in the past, and that's defending versus ecos, which sounds like it should be the easiest thing in the world, right? Because, hey, your opponent doesn't have any rifles, but HellRaisers have been struggling mightily versus eco rounds, and this tournament so far, they've been playing the anti-eco rounds really nicely. Even though they might lose quite a few people here and there, they still managed to eke out the round, and for HellRaisers, that's a massive improvement.
It is, absolutely. I mean, before Gamescom, the matches that we were watching from HellRaisers, man, you know, it was turning into that that gamble, you know, are HellRaisers going to be able to get this anti-eco or not?
Yeah.
Well, they were turning into the poster boys of how not to do an anti-eco. So I'm glad to see that they've put a lot of attention, a lot of focus on that. Good flashes in here by Zeus to try and clear up Cat. Doja is waiting on the other side, though, and holding a good angle to dodge those flashes. But this will be a B-split play after all. Edward takes point, not going to find the kill on Markloff, and that sets it up for Kuchar. The crossfire is real. Kuchar just guns them down as they round the corner. Three kills solo by him. And HellRaisers, this is it. This is the statement. First map of this best of three, and they're already slapping Na'Vi around. Guardian is the last man alive here, but it's a 1v4 situation. He's got the bomb, and he's got 50 seconds, so we can never count Guardian out of a situation, especially when Angel and Markloff are both so low. But HellRaisers, this is their round to lose at this point.
It really is, and I like what HellRaisers are doing. I'm starting to dislike... Well, now I like it. They're playing together. They've, well, kind of broken up in two duos, Adrian and Markloff on the A-bomb site, and they have the possibility to cover for each other. Same thing with Kuchar and Angel, so this is looking really good for HellRaisers.
Yeah, good coordination. They've really taken their time with this, and one low HP member with the full HP member as well, just to make sure that they really split it up and make life difficult for Guardian. Adrian, not interested in letting his teammates get the frag, jumps down into CT spawn and will find Guardian with the flank, but that puts HellRaisers on their 15th round here on this first map. Na'Vi having no impact whatsoever in the second half on their T side. And Na'Vi, I expect for them to take as long a break as possible and really just try and talk everything over here, because they have to figure out how they can deal with this team, this HellRaisers, the A-team on Inferno. Like, that's what it's going to be all about here for Na'Vi. They have to figure out exactly what kind of mistakes they're doing, and quick.
Yeah, and it's a big task going up against the HellRaisers team playing this well. They do get a good start off for once now, and start with Starx picking up Angel in mid, and that leaves Kuchar quite alone on the B-bomb site. So if Na'Vi are able to recognize this, they could pounce on that and probably get a pretty easy plant.
He's not on the site either, and that smoke is about to clear. And yeah, Na'Vi are going to get out onto the B site before he can even get back onto the bomb site. He has to be worried right now about getting flanked, and there he is. Seized from the B doors, we'll find him waiting on B slope, and that's going to be a very easy kill for Na'Vi. And Guardian doesn't even need to take this fight. He confirms. He sees that two guys are over on A. So they know that HellRaisers are nowhere near this site. Na'Vi in a terrific position here in this round.
Yeah, this is definitely going to be a Na'Vi round. Now it's all down to how many HellRaisers players can they take out, or how many are they willing to hunt after, because their economy is still pretty bad at this point. So if they lose three members, they're not going to be able to get a full buy. So they have to be careful about that while going for the HellRaisers members, because HellRaisers are going to be able to buy either way.
Yeah, HellRaisers are the ones who have the bank, but also have a huge amount of space to work with, just considering the rounds, because they maintain that 10-round lead. And look at what HellRaisers do. Instantly, double off play from them. Markelov, who's been doing fantastic throughout the first half, and he continues to do so in the second half. And Kucher now, one of the an opper that, you know, has gotten a lot of praise for HellRaisers. We haven't seen him op too much after Gamescom because Markelov stated that he would be the main opper for the team. But still, Kucher is not to be taken lightly. He can definitely get damage done with this AWP.
Absolutely. And I kind of like the fact that HellRaisers are trying out new things and trying the double op setup. Normally, we don't see Kucher op that much outside of Inferno, where he does an excellent job. So HellRaisers trying out things, they do have the room to make errors at this point as well. So I like the fact that HellRaisers are trying something new.
Absolutely. It's good. I mean, this could be, I mean, why not? It's not a huge risk to take. They have so much space to work with. And yeah, okay, if the double op makes it work, you know, they don't give Na'Vi many rounds. I think the big thing here for Na'Vi at this point is just how many rounds can they get before HellRaisers get that final round and try and, you know, work out the kinks a little bit to give them some confidence going into the next map here, because Angel and Markelov already going toe-to-toe on this A site. They're still alive. Markelov is still here on A slope. He will pick off Zeus. Starks at the top of mid right now, going to catch the rotation, and he almost manages to get two frags, which would have been fantastic for him. Angel getting slowed down, but that bomb is alive on the A site, and it should be getting planted fairly soon here, unless Edward decides to YOLO down into CT and get one kill. Okay, Edward. He's going for the win here. He's not messing around. He knows he has to take this fight. He finds Markelov. But now he has to worry about Doja. And Doja is one step ahead. Doja's already going to be in upper dark when this bomb gets planted.
Oh, this is painful to watch. There's no way Edward can know this is happening.
Bomb has been planted. Oh, Doja. Oh, Doja. It's just perfect. It's perfect. How does he just read it? He read Edward like a book. He knew exactly what Edward is going to do.
That's that experience coming into play right there, and HellRaisers cap off an insane game. An insane game to start off of. For those of you who didn't catch the best of three they played last night, Na'Vi won that 2-0, and they won 16-6 on Dust 2. So now we're just seeing HellRaisers flip it completely and get out of the first map, which is Na'Vi's map pick, 16-5. And this is why we talk about HellRaisers being, you know, showing up with their A team or their B team, because the inconsistency or the level of play, the difference in level of play between those two teams are just that big.
Yeah, and we can see consistency across the board right now in the frags as well. It's not one guy standing out doing a lot of the work. It's everybody in the teens, everybody lending a hand. But guys, we're going to take a quick commercial break before we get into our second map here of this best of three. Na'Vi are not done yet. They will have a chance to redeem themselves on Inferno. We'll be back to watch that in 5 minutes' time.